Hello, welcome to NetVN channel. In this video I show you how to create a partition for Windows 11 system recovery when something goes wrong. Here I have a computer running Windows 11. The operating system is installed on partition C. You should name this partition Windows 11 to avoid confusion in the following step. Also in this computer there is another partition, it's called data, I'll cover it later in the video. You go to Microsoft's homepage and download the installer for Windows 11 operating system. If the Windows 11 installer ISO file is available on your computer, you can skip this step. I download the Windows 11 64-bit installer. Next, I use the Rufus tool to create a bootable Windows 11 installer. The purpose of this installer is to boot the computer into the command prompt. You can use the Windows Pay Suite if you have one available. I recommend that you use a USB stick with at least 8 GB capacity to create the Windows 11 installer. You move the ISO file to another partition to reduce the usable size of the OS installation partition. Next, you restart the target computer and boot from the newly created USB stick. To do so, you access the BIOS or UEFI and set the boot order. My computer uses an ASUS motherboard and I set it up to boot from a USB stick as follows. Then you save the changes and restart the target computer. A screen to prepare to install Windows 11 appears. But here you use the CTRL-F10 key combination to open the command window. In the command prompt you use the disk part command to define the partitions on your computer. With the command list vol 1 know that the operating system installation partition is C, in addition there is a D partition named data. The purpose of this step is to capture the current state of the operating system and create a file named install.wim. You use this file to restore the system when something goes wrong or restore to your best state. To capture the current state of the operating system you use the dism command. Here the file is saved in partition D and named install.wim. The operating system installation partition is C. So I have successfully captured the C partition, I restart the target computer. Don't forget to set the computer to boot from the hard drive. Now you can remove the USB stick from it. As you can see, there is a file named install.wim in the partition named data. Next, I create a new partition to restore the system if needed. This partition must be larger than the install.wim file. So I will shrink the current D partition and create a new one. To ensure the size to save the install.wim file, I create a new 10 GB partition and name it recovery. And this is the partition I just created. What are you going to do with it? Stay tuned for the next step of the video. You mount the Windows 11 ISO file downloaded from the Microsoft homepage to get the files in this installer. You copy all the files and paste in the newly created partition. Next, you navigate to the folder named Source. Here you find and delete the original install.wim file of the Windows 11 installer. After deleting the original file, replace it with the install.wim file you just created in the previous step. The file you just created is usually larger in size than the original file but has the same name. You paste the custom install.wim file to the folder named Source in the partition named Recovery. At this point, this partition has all the necessary files. Next, you set it up to create a dual boot every time you power on or restart your computer. To do that, you use the file with the following commands. I will put this file in the description. You save this file with the extension bat. I name this file recovery.bat. This file will help you add a system recovery option when you power on your computer. You open this file with administrative rights. Next, enter the drive letter where the system recovery files are saved. That's the partition you just created in which to store your custom install.wim file. In this example, my drive letter is Z, this partition is named recovery. You enter the drive letter and press enter to run the command. I will delete this file from the computer and restore the system. If this file is restored, then I have succeeded. After deleting the file, I restarted the target Windows 11 computer and started to recover it. Please take a moment to support NetVN channel with a t-shirt at the bottom of the video. Or click like and subscribe. A system restore option appears, I'll choose it. The Windows 11 installation screen appears, do the following steps. You will delete the partition where Windows 11 is currently installed. Then restore your system with your custom installer. It will copy files and install Windows 11 operating system. After a while, your computer will reboot. Now you boot into Windows 11. You don't have to set up keyboard, language, username, password. Although I deleted the file from this computer, now it is restored. And this is the recovery partition that I want to show you in this video. Now every time you want to restore your computer, just use this partition. Good luck, thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe.